As a baseball fan growing up in San Diego, I was lucky. I got to watch Tony Gwynn play every day. He never showed off and never took a playoff. He just showed up and worked his butt off every single day for his entire career. One of the things I loved most about Tony was that he was always trying to get better. Before the days of iPads and laptops, he'd haul video equipment from city to city on road trips to study his at-bats and scout opposing pitchers, something no one else was doing at the time, which is why they called him Captain Video. Instead of doing it through preparation, a lot of the elite guys were cheating and getting freakishly big at the height of the steroid era, but Tony never juiced, and he was still the best. He was so good that he hit over 300 in every season of his career, except his first, despite having an increasingly overweight body by Betty Crocker. His words, not mine. T. Gwynn's 338 career batting average is the highest of any player who began his career after World War II, and will probably never be matched. The current active career leader is Detroit's Miguel Cabrera, with a 321 average that's 17 points lower than Gwynn. It's kind of impossible to overstate how dominant Tony was at getting on base. He three-peated as baseball's batting champion from 1987 through 1989, and then four-peated from 94 to 97. Only four other players have ever won four straight batting titles. But despite all that success, he never left San Diego for a better team or a more lucrative contract. That's why Petco Park's address is 19 Tony Gwynn Drive, and why he'll always be Mr. Padre, because he loved us and the city we shared just as much as we loved him. No matter how many losing seasons we suffered through, we always had number 19 patrolling right field and using that sweet swing to crack balls through holes in the infield. We loved him because in college, he was a first-team All-American on the San Diego State baseball team and is still the single-season and career record holder in assists in Aztecs basketball history. Not only was he the most legendary athlete ever to play in San Diego, Tony Gwynn was also a legendary person. He was honored for his character and humanitarianism with the 1995 Branch Rickey Award, the 1998 Lou Gehrig Memorial Award, and the 1999 Roberto Clemente Award. These are achievements the USA Today called baseball's triple crown of humanity and kindness. Tom Verducci of Sports Illustrated called Gwynn, quote, an ambassador not just for the game of baseball, but for mankind. So I know I speak for all San Diegans when I say I'm grateful to Tony for all the memories and for the example he set. He was the best, and he'll always be missed.